What's up? In this video, we're going to be talking about what's the best trading software out there. My name is Mohsen, and this is Montreal Trading Group. We're a proprietary trading firm, so we know all about trading. Now, out of all the softwares that we've used throughout the years, this is by far the best one, the easiest one to use, no problems, intuitive. It's by far the best, and let me show you why. So we'll log in right now. So Tradingview.com. So the software is actually Tradingview. And I'll go over a few of the things that I think make it so good. And then I'll let you judge for yourself. So as soon as you get on the page, the first thing you see, top authors. So these are people who put their trading alerts or trading ideas out there. You can follow them. You can see what they think is going to happen to, you know, a stock and the explanation for it. You can comment on it. So very useful. I gotta admit, I don't use this as often, but if you're a new trader and you want to get some ideas, follow some of the guys who have some good ratings and see what they do and learn from them. So this is something that's very helpful. Again, I haven't used it that much. Now, the really nice thing about Tradingview is you have access to all the markets. You have all the currencies, Spain stocks, Indian stocks, anything you want, you're going to be able to get it there. Now let's jump into the charts, because that's what you're looking for. So when you go on the charting, usually you're going to be met with this page. And let me just take this off. And you have your daily chart for whatever stock you want to look at. Let's say Apple. Okay. You can basically do anything you want to do, anything on these charts. So if you want to draw some trend lines, you can go on trend line and draw the trend line that you want. Okay, here you go. Easy as that. Fully customizable. You can double click on it, change the color, change the size. Whatever you want to do, you can do really on here. Okay, you want to put a pitchfork. I don't know why you would use that, but here you go. You can do that as well. Any type of indicator you'll find on. If you're doing videos or if you're an educator, super nice. You can write things on it, draw stuff. You can put text by here, whatever color you want, and you can move it anywhere you want. So fully interactive. Very easy to use, and as you see, you want to use Elliott waves, whatever type of patterns you can think of, they have it, right? If you're going to be, let's say you want to do a long position somewhere, maybe you want to buy here, and you want to see your profit and loss, well, you can just put a, and use this tool, put your entry price, your stop price, your take profit price, and then you'll actually have your ratio for win-loss return. So very easy to use and very visual. So no other platform has this. We actually used to use eSignal, which I actually have here. I'll open it right now. Back in the days, everybody used eSignal. eSignal was the charting software that all traders used. Okay, it was the best one out there. And that's the one we've used. We're still subscribed to it. But again, it's uncomparable right now. So this actually reminds me that I have to cancel my subscription. But we still have it, but it's not as user-friendly. Sometimes it bugs and you open it and there's no quotes. And it's more expensive, okay? And I'll come back to the pricing of this one because you can actually use it for free if you want. But as of this point, everybody here is using TradingView, and everybody that I know honestly uses this. What else can you use? Icons. If you want to put some icons on it, you can do that. Zoom in, zoom out, measuring stuff. So you can really do whatever you want in terms of drawing on it or simplifying things for yourself by putting them on the chart. Now, indicators. If you want to put indicators, all you got to do is right-click, or you can actually go on indicators here, or right-click and click on insert indicator, and you have every type of indicator you can think of. Okay? So if you want to add a Bollinger Band, just put in Bollinger. Here, Bollinger Band. And you have so many different ones. And you just add it. And, oh, here's your Bollinger Band. Add it. If you want to add something else, let's say an RSI, relative strength indicator, put in RSI. Oh, here it is. Just add it. And it's at the bottom, right? And again, you can change things. If you want to change your levels on the RSI, you can do that. If you want to insert a moving average, again, simple moving average, SMA. Here we go. And you got your moving average. If you want to change the moving average from, let's say, it defaults at 7. Let's say you want a 200 period moving average. Put in 200. Here you go. So super simple to use. Has all the indicators you want. Now, on top of all of that, and this is why I think it could be very beneficial, if you're trading, and let's say I'm trading this stock here, okay, and you say, okay, well, oh, this looks like a support level, I'd want to buy it if it breaks below this level. You can just right-click and click Add Alert. And if you do that, it'll tell you, okay, well, what is your condition? Condition is that this stock crosses the value of this. When that happens, I want you to show me a pop-up, play a sound, send me an email, even send me a text message. So you can create your alerts just like that. And then you have an alert created. And whenever the price falls to that level, you're going to get an alert. So you'll know about it. And you'll see here, I have so many alerts, right? And this is the, in this section, you can watch your alerts. So I have so many alerts, and this is the alerts log. I had so many alerts that were sent out to me today, and yesterday, and the day before. So very useful if you're looking at a lot of stocks. Another thing that's super useful is you can actually click here and see multiple stocks at the same time. So if you want to see one stock, you click on this. But if you want to see four stocks at the same time, you can click on this. And then you have four windows. So you can monitor four symbols at the same time. Super, super useful. You can actually go up to eight if you want. Now, time frames. Now we're looking at a daily chart. You can actually click on daily and then see, well, do you want 1 month chart, 1 hour charts? Okay, so you can check 1 hour charts. You can check 5 minute charts, 1 minute chart if you want. Okay, so every type of time frame is available on there and super easy, super intuitive to use. You can actually do way more things. You can actually combine symbols. That's more advanced, but it gives you the opportunity to do things like that. If you want to create or publish your own ideas, you can do that. You can have people follow you. So that's also something available. Now, the other nice thing, watch list. You can click on here and you have your watch list. So these are symbols that you want to watch for. So these are the symbols I'm watching today and or that I've been watching for the past few weeks. If I want to add another symbol to them, let's say Apple, I'll just go here and say Apple and it gets added to my watch list. So super easy to follow them in that way. And you can have a lot of different watch lists. You'll have I have one for Brazilian stocks, Bovespa, and Hong Kong stocks, and foreign exchange. So I have different watch lists for different things that we trade, right? So again, very useful to have that on. That being said, there's way more things you can do on them, and it lets you play around with it because you just learn by playing around with it, I guess. You actually have another one nice part is going to be the hot list. So things that are moving today, biggest gainers, biggest loser. You have a calendar if there's big news on something. Everything you want. Now, pricing, which is what you want to know about it. To be honest, okay, so the one I'm using right now is the Pro Plus. And that's the one we're all using, actually. You can actually start using the free version. Okay, you can use the free version and it's going to meet your needs for most people, right? For most people, it's going to meet your needs. If then you require more, go to the Pro, okay? And then if you require more, go to the Pro Plus. If you require more, go to Premium. So don't just go and buy one of them right away. Start off with the most basic one. Once you want to use an indicator or something and it tells you, oh, you need to be a Pro member to use that, then upgrade. So don't upgrade right away. Wait until you need it. The main difference, honestly, between like Premium and all of these, well, on the free one, you can only have one chart. On the Pro, you can have two. On the Pro Plus, you can have four. Premium, you can have 8. So we don't even need to have 8. So we just use the Pro Plus. Devices on the same account. Well, if you want to be able to log in from two different accounts, two different computers, well, you need a Pro Plus. If you need 5 computers, you need a Premium. How many alerts are you going to be using? Free, you can only use 1. Pro, 10. Us, we use more, so that's why we get the Pro Plus. How many indicators are you going to put per chart? So again, in the beginning, you can start off with the free. As soon as you see you need more, go to Pro. If you need more, go to Pro Plus. Okay? And the pricing is honestly super affordable. And you can just go on a monthly plan where you're paying, you know, I guess if you go monthly, it's probably going to be more expensive than that. But on the Pro, it's $10 a month, which is nothing. On the Pro Plus, $20 a month, which is nothing. Again, we were paying like $100, but that's including the quotes for eSignal per month. So again, that's super inexpensive, even for the Premium. To be honest, it's not expensive at all. So this is honestly the best charting software out there. Give it a try. I'm actually going to put a link in the comment section, and I've probably put one up on the screen somewhere if you're watching this on YouTube. Go on it. I'll make it lead to our page so you can follow us, because I want to start putting more of our ideas on there so you can follow our ideas as well. If not, I'll put our name into the comments so you can follow us as well. That being said, subscribe to our channel and like this video. Take care, guys.